entire temple. We never gonna call it like most of our temple. It's not only Buddhist temple. Yeah, we never gonna call it Buddhist temple because it's always mixed with like Thai. I mean, Buddhist, Hindu or Taoism. So in one temple, we always call Thai temple. We not really call it Buddhist temple.
Okay.
Like, because like what they would like to talk in this law about like in Thailand, we have 68 million people in the whole country. Like 92% we are Buddhist, 7% is Muslim, and there's 1% mixed with like Sikh, Catholic, Hindu, or another religions. You can say like Buddhists are the biggest one, right? But it never mean Buddhists are strongest one in Thailand. Like in Thailand, it doesn't matter even you are Muslim, Sikh, Catholic, or whatever. You always have the same power with Buddhism because in Thailand, we never use religion to make power and we don't compare the religions.
Yeah.
It doesn't matter what your family believe about, but when you were young, your family tried to give you a simple information about all the religion we have in the whole country. When you get to the first school, you have to get the information about all the religion we have in the whole country again. So they are not desired or they are not controlling which religion that you have to go into or you have to be in the religions. Which one that you want to go or you don't want to be in any regions is all up to you. But the main reason that they have to give you information because they have to make sure or they want to make sure you know how to be respect to the other. You must know like what you can do with this one. You must know like what you cannot do with this one. And you must know like what you should do with this one. It's very common sometimes that you see like Muslim people come to temple or go to the church, or Buddhist people we go to the church, go to the mosque, like Catholic people come to the temple or go to the mosque. We all go everywhere, but it never means we go because we're in that region. Sometimes we just go because we are respect the regions and people inside the region because we got to like because we got to teach or we believe as in we young, every region they teach you to be a good person. Don't have any region that teach you to be a bad person and that they have no reason to be empty to the other. Have reason to be respect to everyone. And like as you can see over there at the Portuguese area we just finished is the Catholic area, right?
Yeah.
Not far from there here's a huge temple. And behind this is a Muslim mosque. So you can see like they live in the same area. But you never gonna see that people are separate or like difference at all because we learn to understand each other and we use that to stay with each other. And how it can work like that, you guys have to understand the main culture that we have in Thailand. The three big main culture that we have in Thailand is same like Japan, like polite, respect and kind. So this training you're gonna get trained either from your family since you're young. They're gonna be able to train you how to be polite to everyone, how to be respect to the other people and how to be kind to each other. This is exactly what we use to stay together. And it's the reason why Thai people are quite easy to smile and quite friendly because we always have three of these things that you consider all the time when you do something. You got it?
Very nice.
And also like as you can see the Buddhists are the biggest population here, right? Because like okay, I would love to share a symbol of it. Like Buddhists in Thailand, first thing you need to know, like we don't use this like a region. Buddhism in Thailand is more like education and lifestyle because Buddhism in Thailand we don't have God. We only have Buddha and Buddha for us is not God. He's like normal guy but who's the one that who follow the way to live your life or make your life better and just share to you. So we follow his lifestyle, his way. So we respect him like a teacher, we don't respect him like a God. So only one thing that we believe the most in Thai Buddhism, it is karma. You guys know karma?
Karma,
yeah.
Yes.
So we believe whatever you do or whatever you did, you will get the effect back. Maybe you not get it right away when you done it. Maybe not in 10 days, maybe not in 10 years, or maybe not in this life, but we believe for sure you will get it back. A real Buddhism from the scripture, what Buddha like shared to us, or what Buddha, like what we learn from the scripture, he never teach or he never tell people to wait or to believe about luck. Because like, luck is mean nothing in Buddhism because we believe everything that happened, it never happened by luck. It all happened by karma or the thing that you did in the past and decide for what you have right now. And what it's gonna be with you in future from what you think from now. You got it? So if you say luck to make you guys easy to understand first, some people that they get bad luck, it doesn't make sense at all. And they think back to the past, what they did, why they have to get this, and they couldn't think it out. That we believe the thing you've done in your period life and the karma just come back to you by now. So what you can see between this, you can see you cannot run away from karma. Even you die, you're born again, so you get the thing that you've done back to your life. But what you can do, you can prepare your mind to be strong enough when you get bad karma back to you. You're not going to be so fear because otherwise you cannot go back in your period life or period time to change anything, right? And if your mind are strong enough, you're never gonna do any bad karma in the future. So that's why what the main activity that we do the most in Thai Buddhism is meditation. you don't pay lecture for that. Yeah, you guys know. Yeah, like the main activity that we do the most in Thai Buddhism is meditation. Have you guys ever done meditation?
Yes.
Okay, I've never done it.
You never done it?
No.
So what meditation means for you guys?
Like to distract your mind for like the how do you say pensamientos?
From your thoughts.
Yeah. For me, you go inside yourself and you focus on your breath.
Yeah, like you're more like a relax yourself or cleanse your moods and
everything. Observing your thoughts, sharing
your thoughts. Yeah. Okay. Inner peace, and you know, being happy with yourself and not seeking outside distraction.
Gotcha. Yeah, like, so I would like, so meditations, it helps so many style, so many ways to do meditation. It depends on what you use for. Some people, they use meditation for like healthy, like yoga, like.
Yes.
And some people just use it for like finish your day or end your day or like start your day or like clean your mind, whatever. Some people use for less, like it's very helpful for fix your system, like your body system. But if you look to any meditation, it's the same concept. Like every meditation, if you look very straight and try to understand it, it means be at the moment, or it's always training you to be at the moment or be in the person.
Yeah.
So what we teach time, like what we teach in Thailand about meditation is, you can do meditation all the time. Every moment of your life, every pace of your life, anywhere or anytime, like you don't need to sit down, keep quiet and close your eyes to do meditation. You can do meditation whenever, as long as you understand yourself, like you know exactly like who you are, what are you doing and what you have to do. Even not like that, we call be aware, be awake.
Yes.
You get it?
Yes.
So the reason that they teach you by this way, even in Thailand, because it's the most like sitting in quiet area, close your eye and focus up like this, because that is the most simple way to train you how to like to focus up like things, or how to like let you feel what the meditation feel like, or how to the meditation feeling, but how to adapt it to use in your life. That is what we more consider in Thai Buddhism. Make a sample, if you walk, you and yourself that you're walking, right? You know where you're going to, and you focus up your step and your way, you're not gonna be filled out. Also you work, you know yourself that you're working, you know what you have to work for, and you focus up your job, you're not gonna do a mistake by yourself. Also, like we say in Thailand, like we are a normal people that living in normal life. In our life all the time, a lot of things come to our life, are coming to our life all the time. If you run follow with everything or keep everything that come to your life, then you're gonna get crazy, then you will get lost, like no one who have enough time for everything that have come to your life. But how to see what you should spend time and spend energy to keep follow and keep doing it. You might see it more clear, or you only can see it when you exactly understand yourself, like when you know exactly like who you are, what you're doing and what you have to do. Even though like that at yourself, you will see more clear what is important for you, that you want to spend time, or you should spend time and spend energy to keep follow and keep doing it. You understand this one? Same thing like in Buddhism, you know like that at yourself, you believe in karma, you know what karma gonna bring back to you. You never gonna do any bad karma.
Yes.
Yeah, so that, you understand it, right? So that's why I say like Buddhism in Thailand is not about regeneration, it's more about how to live your life, or how to understand yourself. Yeah. Like even I say that we believe in karma, but that just means you believe in yourself, because the one who do or the one who desire you, all karma is you. So that's why a lot of Thai people that go for Buddhism, because they feel like flexible, they feel like their life, not dating to anything, that their life depends on them. They are the one who decide their life.
Yeah.
You got it? Yeah, so that's the reason why a lot of Thai people go for Buddhism.
Very nice.
Yeah, understand it?
Yes.
So you can say like, people who use the Buddhism for lifestyle, they have no religions, like me, I have no religions.
Yeah.
Same.
I mean like, I don't, even like, okay, Buddhism.
What, can I ask you a question? Do you call yourself a Buddhist?
I call Buddhist because Buddhist, it is the way of life.
It's your way of life.
Actually, like from the scripture, Buddha said it's the way of life. Yeah. It's not about
it's not
pay
religion.
To him. Buddha, he never tell us to pay to him or to make the wish to him.
Yes.
Correct.
Because he cannot tell you anything.
Yes.
Like he said, you can pay if you feel good about it, but the one who can help yourself better is yourself.
Yourself.
Yeah. Like so, yeah, like if who understand Buddhism, like we are called, we are Buddhist of lifestyle.
Correct.
Yeah,
yeah, we're not Buddhist of religions.
Not religions. Mm-hmm.
But also like, as you can see, even in Thailand, like I said that, but the way I do in Thailand also is quite confused, because before Buddhism, we got used to be Hinduism before,
mm-hmm.
and actually Buddhism is transferred from Hinduism.
Correct.
So like some people, something that we used to believe in Hinduism or we used to do in Hinduism is also get to Buddhism also.
Correct.
But the main of Buddhism is like the way of life or the real.
Correct.
Life. Right. Do you understand it?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, yeah.
Okay, any question?
Why people come and pray and bow to the Buddha?
So first thing that is people are few. So the reason that they create temple, mm-hmm. or the reason that they have like monk, mm-hmm. the long time ago that they have monk because they want them to know or to learn about it. But like after that, like when we have monk and people share, but they would like to share that their idea or their knowledge to people. So that's why they create the temple.
Mm-hmm.
And people come to temple because they want to get to understand.
Mm-hmm.
And that it make them like, some people come to temple. I never go temple. I mean, after I've been a monk, I don't go temple for myself.
You've been a monk?
Yeah, like for long, like 5-6 years ago.
Like, how long?
For 6 months. So people go to be a monk, sometimes they're, I mean, some people go to a temple, sometimes they get lost, sometimes they feel like, they get confused about their life.
Mm-hmm.
It's make them feel good that they come to close to Buddha and see like how to say like
come to earth.
Yeah, come to like come back to like what they used to be or what they used to try before, to try to be before.
Mm-hmm.
You know, even I say that we try to live at the moment, it sounds simple, it sounds easy, right? But it's not easy to do.
Mm-hmm.
No.
Like they said your mind is a monkey.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Your mind is like
yeah.
all around.
Yeah.
It's very hard to control.
Yeah. Yeah.
You have to like that why meditation is one of the is a part of the way of life,
mm-hmm.
because if you keep practicing yourself to like focus
mm-hmm.
every day,
mm-hmm.
it's like long time. Is you will get like better. And I say like that. Okay, so I will tell a symbol of my experience that maybe help you to understand it. Like to be honest, when I was young, I'm not a good person.
Like
you're only 25 now?
Yeah, but when I was like teenager, I'm quite bad. Yeah.
You're
like,
doing what you
bad things.
Alcohol.
I'm a gang people.
Gang?
Wow.
What?
Yeah. Gang people.
From the gangs.
Wow.
But
oh,
like
wow.
that when I was 13 to 17.
Oh.
Years. So I'm a person who lost control so easy. I'm a person who like don't care anyone. I never take things seriously for a long time, just like having fun every day, just don't really care about anything. But I just found myself, because the reason why I always be the kind of person, because I always live with the past and think about the future. So what it means by that, like I try to pretend myself like I'm not afraid, I'm not scared,
mm-hmm.
don't worry, but because I always like that, because I live with what I mistake in the past and fear about the future, what is gonna happen by that. So living with fear and fail, your mood is not stable.
Mm-hmm.
So that's why like you don't want people to see about it. You pretend yourself like you are strong.
Yeah, yeah. Yeah.
But actually it's always scared.
Mm-hmm.
Like, I don't believe that people are going to die and don't be scared.
Mm-hmm.
Like
oh,
you
not
go
being
do
scared of death.
Yeah.
Yeah. No, I don't think no one who don't scared of death.
Mm-hmm.
Like even you see gang people like point the gun, they're scared but they have to pretend themselves to be like
mm-hmm.
So after I got to be like one so at once, like my mom asked me to be a monk. I didn't decide to be by myself. So my mom asked me to go to be a monk, and after I became a monk, I got to learn a real meaning of meditation, and that is make myself like it make me saw myself like very clear. So
it helped you.
Yeah, like the guy who like I'm lucky, a bit lucky, because when I did a monk at the countryside, it's not much of people. Go on that time,
mm-hmm.
and almost every new monk they have like a personal teacher, like
mm-hmm.
an old monk that be like your personal teacher
oh,
that
so
teaches you. So you have more time to talk,
mm-hmm.
more time to talk. He make everything simple, but it totally makes sense. Like he said, like you can't think about the past, but you should not put any feeling or live with the past because you cannot change anything in the past. Right? But what you can get by thinking about it, you can get an idea. what you did or what you mistake in the past and get the idea how to be at the moment,
mm-hmm.
and make it to be the best at last that you can. And for the future thing, like not only in Buddhism but in any people, like okay, especially with Thailand, we say we are going to die every day. Like no one know, like we have this time every day. Like no one know exactly mm-hmm. when it's gonna be your last day.
Mm-hmm.
We don't know what is mm-hmm. gonna happen with you tomorrow. Even don't know like you're
in
gonna wake
minutes,
up
yeah,
tomorrow.
Yeah,
yeah.
yeah.
So they say like don't. He said to me like don't think too much about the future because you cannot see and you cannot
mm-hmm.
control it.
Mm-hmm.
So what you can do the most like
the present.
Yeah, like so you learn from what you. Make a simple leap. You learn from what you did in the past and get the idea to live at the moment and make it to be the best and most as you can. If your that day or your last day come to you, you're not gonna be fail or sad. You know, you didn't do the best that you can before.
Mm-hmm.
And also like if you live your life to be the moment and make it to be the best, if you have it can be calamity for the future. If you have future, you might be better, you might be stronger
mm-hmm.
than how you're doing right now because everything that's going to be with you in future. From what you decide to do or what you're doing right now.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So that's the same thing. Like it's a how to say like it's the same thing like what we believe in about the how to say what temple why people come to temple. Like we come because we want to get close to understand like
to understand
yeah
to
like
look.
The I don't know how to explain it to English.
Yeah.
But it's kind of like how to understand
yes.
or how to bring your back
yes.
to the moment.
Yeah.
Yeah.
To the present moment.
Yeah, to the present.
Yeah, it's like a reminder.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, reminder.
Reminder,
yeah.
Reminder,
exactly.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Do you plan at all? Do you any planning?
Yeah, everyone have a plan. I have a plan for my like goal, what I'm going to be, but I don't really expect that too much.
You don't expect that? Okay.
I do expect, but I have to tell myself that it can be or cannot be, but
mm-hmm.
what I can do the most right now is
yes.
what I can do the
Dave right now.
Yeah,
in this
what
moment.
I can do right now is here.
Mm-hmm.
What I can do the most, or like what I can do 100% is right now.
Right.
The future, I cannot do anything about it.
Yeah.
But yeah, of course, everyone should have the plan for your life.
Mm-hmm.
But you should expect that also. It can be or cannot be.